Okay, welcome back to HeroC Podcast. This is for the May 2016 crowd. I want to welcome everyone back. My guest this month is Leslie Bullock. Hello, Leslie.
Hi.
She has been very, very helpful and useful in working with the studio group for MayFest, the beginning of May. Plus, she's helping out also with the reviews for the movies, including Captain America Civil War. So, looking forward to a female perspective, fangirl perspective of that. So we're going to jump right in. Again, this is a reminder of the five C's, what we concentrate on: character, comics, creativity, culture, and, oh Lord, I just lost the fifth one in my head.
Connections.
Thank you. Didn't connect there, did it? That's somewhat appropriate. Okay. First and foremost, I do want to say we've lost a couple of really important people last couple of months, creative individuals. I'm not saying that as a music lover, but Prince having passed away. But just recently this weekend was Darwin Cook. Big DC artist and writer and storyteller who passed away from cancer. He did the DC beginning, the DC age with The Center, which they turned into an animated film with Bruce Timm. So it was really good work. His insights will be missed. So our positive thoughts and prayers go out to your family. Okay. I also want to just mention here locally, a friend of and former member of the Draft Network team, who also guest spots many, many times on the HeroC podcast, Keith Daniel, has had some upset with his family, and so we ask that you send your positive energy his way with his family. They need all the encouragement and help they can get. So we love you, man. Just know that, okay? Okay, let's just jump right in. Leslie, if you're ready. We've got some newsletter updates. Actually, the HC Studio newsletter for May is available. What's the website where you can download the newsletter from Studio?
Here, www.herocentral.org. Just go to, on the main page, you will see a link that says newsletters. That goes straight there. Newsletter image just shows right up. You click on it, and you can download it right there.
Excellent. Okay. So, with Hero Central Studio May updates and new releases, let's go kind of go over what's been updated in the last couple of weeks. New webcomics. What webcomics do they have active going on at the site, the HC site?
Well, right now we're updating the Hero Central Junior. It's almost finished with Chapter 3. So, keep watching and we'll get Chapter 3 fully up there and we'll move on to the next story. N2 Deep is being updated daily. Well, not weekly.
Weekly. I understand there's different artists at different times
exactly.
In this volume.
I think we're almost done with one of Don Chewy's groupings.
Excellent. Hey, Don, how are things in New Zealand? Yes, Don Chewy is an artist around in New Zealand who's worked with us in the past and will hopefully continue to work for us. So, yay, Don. He's now teaching art at the university. So, go, Don.
Congrats, Don. Also, we have Guaylo Pax, which is a chibi manga series by Jason Bullock.
Huh, sounds familiar.
I wonder who that is.
I wonder.
And we also have Captain Nine, which is one of our sci-fi webcomics, also written by Jason and drawn and everything.
Wow, seems like things are really busy in the webcomics. Now, those are free?
Those are free. Just read them online.
Excellent, excellent.
And we try to send out updates to let you know when we've updated everything. We've got new ones coming out soon.
Okay.
As soon as he does them.
So if they join up the on the newsletters and join the news group, they can automatically get updates each
just
month?
Just let us know. You can sign up to be on our mailing list.
Okay.
And we will just send you out weekly or so. However often we update, which is usually weekly.
Excellent. Okay, you heard her, guys and gals out there in fan world. Make sure you sign up on the actual email list of the group. Again, that's herocentral.org. Okay, so we know that Hero Central Universe issue, double issue number 1617. That's 40 pages. That's $6 in the double side color cover book. Is now available on site, as I understand it, correct? Okay.
It's available for both digital download and hard copy ordering.
Oh, wow. Again, the storefront at the site is
exactly
available. Or if you can catch us at any of our conventions, we will have it on our persons, as we did at MayFest, and we sold quite a few. So I hope everyone enjoys their books. I'm listening for a response, people. Email us, let us know how things went, and how you enjoyed our books. We did want to give a special shout-out thanks to Anthony Greco over at Greco Printing for his timely and life-saving assist in getting the books printed.
And not just life-saving, sanity-saving. We've had a crazy time then.
Thanks again, Anthony. You guys keep up the good work, and we'll definitely be back in business with you for the next issue. Okay, HCU2 number 1 is also available. It's sporting a cover by Marcus Huff and our famous colorist, Steve Lisewski. Various artists and various writers will be submitting to this series, but in this first particular issue, myself, I entered 2 stories, and Marcus drew 1 additional one. I'm introducing all new characters for the Space Saga version, and the connecting stories with our Hero Central main line. So you guys need to pick that up. Again, digital and hard copy, as she's nodding her head that you guys can't see. Okay. Just so you know, we'll be moving through the different seeds at different times, so we're not really going to tag them this time, but we do have some very specific things that are available, like our creativity section. I'm going to give a shout-out to Medibang, M-E-D-I-B-A-N-G, for their awesome free source art program, which you can go to cnet.com and download it. To Dwango in Japan for the release of the OpenToons Ghibli version, which allows us noobs to do vector-based animation. So all you Miyazaki fans, cha-ching on the OpenToons program. Also to Pascal Nadon and Patrick Corrieri for their great open-source animation software, 2D Pencil.
How is that, anyway?
That's a great program. It gives you the basics on animation, and it's basically like using your pencil and onion skin layers and going cell by cell by cell, and the computer helps you move it along in traditional style animation. So you see all these advertisements with these wide erase draw boards and all these animations for stick. That's actually the best way to learn how to do that. So definitely check that out, again, at 2dpencil.org. Okay. Updates and events, newsletters. We actually have a new set of event dates for several things going on around the state of Georgia. Team Lab Future Park, which is now at the Mall of Georgia, starting this weekend and running through July 31st. Mall of Georgia has set up the art exhibit. It's more than any kind of traditional show. Team Lab, Japanese art collective, recognized for their advancements in the digital art practice, are unveiling an interactive high-tech playground in the village for a limited time. Team Lab Future Park is a series of deeply immersive environments designed to foster educational play as well as collaboration through digital art. That sounds a lot of blah, blah, blah. When you actually go online and look at it, you see the opportunity to make imaginary digital creatures and run them through their paces in a virtual world and environment, as well as playing in the physical world with younger kids. They have giant glowing the orbs that are running around in the dark or semi-dark, and they're these giant exercise ball-sized orbs that change music every sounds every time you touch them, and you're playing bumper cars inside of this thing with all everybody else. It's pretty amazing from what they've shown in the original. It's focusing collaborative experiences for children through creativity and play. Guests can explore a digital playground through 7 different living, quote-unquote, works, which use technology to nurture such creative freedom within that environment. And then, like I said, you're encouraged to engage with each other and the art itself to create visual masterworks as well as be part of a bigger team. The 7 immersive works include Sketch Aquarium, Create, Hopscotch for Geniuses, Sketchtown Papercraft, A Table Where Little People Live, Lightball Orchestra, and Connecting Train Block. So there's 7 different areas that are going to be running through July 31st, 2016. So check it out at Mall of Georgia in Buford. Sounds like a lot of fun for the family.
How much is it for that anyway?
Well, actually, it's pretty affordable. You can get the tickets and the village beginning May 14th. Purchase them online at bit.ly/1sjprg_I. That's the actual link site information to get in, which you can Google Team Lab Future Park and you get the same information. General admission is free for children 0 to 2, $8 for children 3 to 13, $12 for adults. They have a ticket rate of $10 available to seniors over 65, students over 14, with a valid group rate. Admission 10 or more is $10 to 6 per child. Looks like they've got some contact information from their website also. All media's inquiries, you can actually email them at tholloway@simon.com or contact Shannon King with Brave Public Relations at 404-233-3993. So, another thing going on around is time again, April 16th through June 5th is the Georgia Renaissance Festival. Bunch of crazy people running around throwing a pickle at you, going look at our people jousting through, looking at the king, looking at the queen, spin stuff in the Middle Ages, minus the Black Plague, you know. Unless you happen to get something that I wasn't aware of. I don't think they had that set up in the shop. But again, GARenFest.com. Everything is set up with special events. They've got several different press releases over the last few months. But what I want to focus on is, again, the entertainment information for 2016 is new. Okay? Plus the 3,000, was it 314? They had new entertainment for 16 awareness. Deaf Awareness Day was March the 14th. Joust the Facts was also a listed information. They've added horse information and Roman weekend on April the 22nd. So all these things have been to come into this area leading you up to what's happening now with May through June. Okay? If you have any questions, go to the website. Check it out again at GARENFEST.com. I want to give a special thanks to Gerald Bird at the Institute of Imagination in Carrollton, Georgia, because he was great with his institute for helping us out with our power situation for when we were at
MayFest,
which also happened to fall on Free Comic Book Day.
Yay!
Which we all love that. Okay, so Leslie, give me a review of what you found to be the highlights, persons of interest, points of overview, or how successful the show was, in your opinion.
Well, I thoroughly enjoyed being able to hang out with Jermaine Webb. He's an awesome artist, and he was working the same table with us. We did see a lot of different type of artwork, a different type of artistry. Like, right next to us, to our right, there was a jewelry shop that they made their own jewelry, but they made it to where it fit certain people. Like, they had to measure you to see if it will...
That's fitting.
Exactly. Thank you. Down the way, they had woodworking. I did notice that. There were a lot of food vendors. And since it was Free Comic Book Day, we were able to give away some of our free... we had a small entertainment activity page for the young children and a double-sided four-page comic for the older children.
So it sounds like it was a lot of activity, a lot of fun. A lot of music events, things going on throughout the day. I know we want to thank the police. They did a great job setting things up, and because an early 7 o'clock in the morning to be there in Carrollton setup time did not come well for a lot of people driving in. But we made it work, and they made it work, and everyone was happy. So I think that's definitely one to watch us for next year in the Central Studio. Okay, conventions that are left for the month of May. Game-O-Rama, which will actually be May 26th through the 30th, is going to be featuring board games, tournaments, panels, and game design and player strategy and flea market of games at Atlanta Marriott Perimeter Center. Then that's going to happen on 26th to the 30th of May. TimeGate is going to be 27th to the 29th. And fans of Doctor Who, TV shows, and Stargate movies can meet celebrities, hear talks, watch shows, play games, and go to a Time Lord party, if they're ready, and cabaret on Saturday, again, at the Marriott Century Center. May 28th and 29th is also handling the Decatur Arts Festival, which has an art walk Friday evening and artists market with live music Saturday and Sunday at Agnes Scott College in Decatur, and it's free to the public. Alpharetta Art Festival will also be the 28th through the 30th. And Alpharetta Art Street Fest offers art, live jazz, acoustical music, cultural law performances, children's activities, and food booths. Again, free to the public. Well, speaking of food, Duluth has now started a Food Truck Friday. So, every Friday through the month of May and through the summer, looks like from 6 to 9 every Friday, zero admission to the main part with free parking inside and public restrooms. Now, the vendors are obviously the ones charging, and the events, there are family events and everything else. The way they describe it is the come out on the Duluth Town Green and enjoy exotic flavors in a mobile vending setting with amazing cuisine. Food Truck Friday will take place every Friday at 6 p.m. from May to October alongside Fridays in Duluth. Enjoy the DFAL Spring Art Walk, food trucks, entertainment, and more. For more information, visit DuluthGA.net. So they definitely follow up. I think you will definitely see us out there on quite a few Friday evenings from here to come. Since they have free admission, friendly group amenities, and it's very group friendly, and it's right off Interstate 85. So a lot of free things to do there. Okay, well, here we are. We've come up to the most important part of the discussion, and that is movie and ephemera. That's going to definitely be under a lot of our seas at this point. So let me give you a few movies and TV things that are coming up, and then we'll do the review for Captain America Civil War. The rest of May the 13th, which just happened. The Curse of Sleeping Beauty just came out, and High Rise. Tom Hiddleston and Clive Owen, Tom Hiddleston, he's in High Rise, which is a self-contained 1970s thriller of people trapped in a high-rise building as if it's undergone its own lockdown in the middle of an apocalyptic economic drop-down, and how this building's people survive at different floors. And so you end up having floor-like wars and takeover and competitions and all kinds of survival issues, and even murder happens. So that's why it's a sci-fi thriller. But it looked really good, to check it out. Okay, so May 20th, Angry Birds. Oh my God. That's exactly what it says in everything he does. But people are going to be looking over for May 27th, though, with Alice Through the Looking Glass, again, another Tim Burton, but also X-Men Apocalypse. My vote's still out on that, with a giant purple marshmallow dude. I've seen better cosplayers than I have in what they did with that guy. But anyway, that's it as far as movies. Okay, let's talk about Captain America Civil War. Okay, Leslie, give me an overview. Now, are we going to deal with spoilers here? Spoiler alert. Turn it down for the next couple minutes if you don't want to hear about this. But you should be spanked for not seeing the movie already. So, go ahead. Your take on it.
Awesome. That's awesome.
Wow, that was pretty quick, wasn't it?
I have a great take, don't I?
Yeah. To the point. Awesome. Okay.
Go watch it.
Why was it awesome?
Well, for one thing, all of the people that were in there that were new, like Ant-Man came over and joined us.
Yes.
We had a visit from Spider-Man.
Yes, Spidey.
So that was pretty cool.
Yeah.
We also got to see more of who the Winter Soldier really is.
Yeah, Bucky no longer.
Exactly, and how they got him to do what he was doing, to do what they wanted him to do.
Yeah, the brainwashing.
How can he actually beat that?
Yeah.
So, that part is in there, too.
What did you think of Black Panther?
Amazing.
Yeah.
I love the suit.
The suit was great.
The suit was awesome. Made of vibranium.
Yeah.
Just like
Captain America's shield.
The shield. because, well, that's where I came from. Yeah. So.
Okay, well, I'll ask you this before I give my review. Which team? Team Iron Man, Team Cap?
I don't know. I'm kind of stuck in the middle. I liked Bucky when he was actually Bucky and when they actually got him under control.
Okay, that's Team Cap.
But I was also not too far against what the ideal was behind Iron Man's decision. It's a very honest and very good idea. Unfortunately, not all ideals are good in practice. Because he would have had to arrest himself for some of the things that he had done.
Theory versus practical.
Exactly.
I like the film, but for very different reasons, actually. From a technical standpoint, it played well, although it didn't play according to the layout of the comic books. It was more true to the character's involvement. Sam Wilson as the Falcon. You got really a chance to see all the things that suit could do, including the Red Wing robot that flew off with him, the drone. That was pretty cool.
That was awesome.
Black Widow was basically set up for her own movie that might be coming out pretty soon. Definitely Black Panther for his film. And then because you even leave with the characters getting his aid in Wakanda. You know, so that's pretty cool. Again, I love the Spider-Man layout. In fact, I found out also through comicbookresources.com that Tony Stark will be making a guest appearance in the new Spider-Man Homecoming movie. I like the younger, quippy teenager banter, pattering, Drake Bell-like off of Web Warriors, you know, and wouldn't shut up Spider-Man, and that's what people were looking for. But my crowning glory was when Ant-Man became Giant Man and fell into the play and did a little imitation of an AT-AT walker out of Star Wars. You know, with the web swinging right around the things. When Spidey kept saying, "Oh, you old people, isn't this in a movie?" And it's like, oh, Lord, that was perfect. It was a really good story. And Vision's conflict with Scarlet Witch, it played out well. When people were complaining about the romance and drama of it, I said, well, that's part of what the Avengers are about. Okay, it's people's interpersonal relationships. And so you can't just have 20 minutes of just utter destruction and nothing else. Oh, well, you can. It's called Game of Thrones. I take that back. Go watch Game of Thrones if that's all you want. Vikings killing each other. Just go watch that. But this movie was really good. So I'm looking forward to the next two Avengers parts, which now have been renamed. It's not going to be part one and two of the Infinity War. But we'll see what the action is. Russo Brothers actually name the action is. But look forward next year to Black Panther. I will give you a little insight as to why you did not see Samuel Jackson in this movie as Nick Fury. It was rumored that with his whole being left out in the second movie, he's gone underground trying to rescue Marvel's Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. and Inhumans off of the television series, which is connected here. But it's rumored that he shows up in the Black Panther movie and is giving aid to the Secret Avengers with the group being helped by T'Challa, the new king of Wakanda, the Black Panther. So, spoilers alert off, you can now listen to what we're talking about. Okay, so as far as other things going on with comic news, I have no idea what the crap's going on in this movie. Marvel, DC, yeah, it's garbage. When it comes to comic books, there's no news. Now, TV and online, Supergirl is now going to be moving for season 2 over to CW from CBS. So there may be more crossovers with The Flash. We just found out that Captain Cold, Leonard Snart, the model actor Wentworth Miller, basically his character died in Legends of Tomorrow this week, but he's going to be showing up, being that it's a time travel movie, in different parts as Captain Cold throughout maybe the other shows, like Arrow or Flash. So he hasn't signed, given his contract, but he's not going to be on any immediate episodes of Legends of Tomorrow. But they're going to be replacing him with future characters. So that looks like it's going to be pretty good. Cartoon Network has decided to just throw a dead fish at us. You know, that's all it is. I mean, I'm looking at their list for their new season, and I'm not happy. I mean, Robot Chicken, The Walking Dead special for Adult Swim. That's just, okay, fine, whatever, so. More zombies, stupid junk.
They're just trying to capitalize on the video games.
Okay, but what about Montana James? Okay, I don't get this feather in the cap explorer from Rip Roaring Syndicated Television Odysseys. Whatever, he's looking for the Holy Grail Cup. I'm looking, and the Order of the Red Armband is on your tail. I don't know about this stuff. Or Mr. Neighbor's House, another educational vignettes, puppets, animation, stop motion, mixed with mediums, and it's done by the people at the Children's Hospital, so I don't like that show anyway. The Clowns Doctors are nice, don't like that. Or a Hot Tub Pie Machine, I'm not interested in that. Same with Brett Gilmer's Dinner in America. That's, oh Lord, awkward comedy sets. It's like an attempt to fill the crap with crap for Adult Swim. I mean, now granted, Samurai Jack is coming back after 12 years, so that's going to be cool. With a series of half-hour episodes. The Dream Corps LLC is like a workplace comedy set, like the Living Color version. I'm not sure about that. Million Dollar Extreme presents World Peace. It's a sketch comedy troupe. Again, another one. You know, it's only going to, it's going to spirit up things that are not right. And then you got stuff like Brad Neely's Hard Nallon's Glopio Peepio. I don't know what that is. I can't even say it right. Okay? Decker Unclassified is a web series, an action bear powerhouse. He subverts terrorist plots against his beloved America. You know, it's a, basically, it's an indie web series that's turned into a full release series. So, FLCL, I'm not sure what's going on with that series, but it's a space saga. But it's more of a Japanese thing, so...
Yeah, what they're doing is bringing FLCL back from the Japanese, because that was...
That was the release.
Yeah, there were a lot of anime music videos with FLCL in it.
Okay.
That people have used, so it's been going on for quite a while. They're just bringing it back over here and playing them all out.
Okay, well, the last three things that I have... I'm worried about this one. Art Prison. In this half-hour live-action pilot, talented convicts vie for one last shot at success... inside a prison for the performing arts, because they have to.